You know what I like? More power.
Installing the unit's easy, just plug it into your OBD2 interface. Next, turn on the ignition and follow the instructions from the DiabloSport. So in the next few scenes, I'm going to go over using the DiabloSport and show you the different features that are available to you. Hey guys, so today we're going to be talking about performance programmers. This one's from DiabloSport. The model we're using is a U7193. Used on GM vehicles, this one's going to be used in a GM pickup. So let's open up the box. So inside you're going to have your instruction manual and your programmer. Before you do anything with the vehicle, read over the instruction manual very thoroughly because it's going to have very specific instructions on how to use the unit. So before you get started, I know you've already read the instruction manual and everything you have to do, but quick reminder for GM owners, they actually want you to pull a couple fuses out. On my particular truck, it's an 05 Silverado. I couldn't find these fuses, so just to make sure I don't have any voltage drops, I made sure that I pulled out the radio, because I'm running an aftermarket one, and I disconnected my aftermarket amplifier. So if you're running any types of aftermarket accessories like gauges, cooling fans, anything like that, I would just go ahead and unplug it just to make sure. So I've already installed the Diablo tune on my truck, but I'm just going to show you guys the different parameters you can go through and different things you can change with it. So I've already installed the performance tune on my truck. It's a daily driver, so I set it up for 87 octane. This is the main screen, so you can go tune it. You can check your diagnostic codes, change options, and check your firmware and everything. So we'll go straight to the good stuff and go to our performance tune. So it's asking me to turn the ignition, but do not start the motor. So here we are now in the different tuning options we can go ahead and install in the truck. So there's a Diablo tune, there's the 87 octane tune, and we can put back in the factory tune in the vehicle. I also want to mention that each tuner that you purchase will be married to the vehicle. So what happens is you're going to download the factory tune onto the unit and then it's going to upload the new tune. But what happens is once the factory tune is actually in the unit, you cannot overwrite it on it. It's a safety thing and that's how they make their money, obviously. So if you were to go into the 87 octane tune, you can go ahead and choose it. Now before you actually install the tune, you can go ahead and modify it. We're not going to install the tune, I'm just going to show you the different parameters you can change. And then we'll go ahead and drive this thing. So if you don't really know what all this stuff is, I wouldn't play around with it too much. So you can change the axle ratio. If you went ahead and you put taller gears in it or whatever, you can change that. We can also change the coolant temperature. You can tell when the cooling fans turn off and on. You can change shift points, idle. Idle is a great thing if you're running a big sound system. You might want to raise the idle up on a bit so the alternator spools up more. Or you can lower by a few hundred RPMs to save on gas if you idle the vehicle a lot. Change your injector slope, get rid of your governor, I've gone ahead and done that. Pressure for part throttle, shift pressure again for the transmission, rev limiter. I didn't play with the rev limiter, I did not play with my transmission. I do have minor transmission work done on this truck, but I didn't want to go ahead and play with it too much. The 87 tune actually does quite a bit, and I also made sure I left torque management on. Yeah, you're going to get a lot more torque between shifts you turn it off, but I just didn't want to risk damaging the transmission at all, so I left all that stuff on. So you see you change your upshift, what speed, wide open throttle fuel and spark, you can change the fuel and the spark curves. I've gone ahead and adjusted that. I made the truck run a little bit more rich. and you can also do Spark Advance as well. So as you can see, the Diablo Predator is a pretty fully loaded unit. I also want to mention, because it's just a flash, not a piggyback system, it is fully compatible with my iData Link and my remote start unit. Alright, so this is my 2005 Silverado. It's got a 4.8 liter V8. So I'm running the DiabloSport Predator in here right now. I'm on the 87 flash tune right now. So basically what I wanted was something that had a little more kick to it, but I didn't have to run premium in it. And quite honestly, I'm pretty satisfied with the tune. Today's review, I'm not giving you any really scientific data. I'm just giving you my personal opinion on how the truck drives. I'm going to give you a little bit of a lowdown on what the truck's got to it. It's nothing serious, but it's a daily driver. Drive it to and from work, just do like little recreational things with it. Motor-wise, it's a full bolt-on vehicle. So nothing crazy, nothing done the internals. So it's got a Canon FIPK, ARA throw-by spacer. You can argue whether that does something or not. JBA headers, and a MagnaFlow performance exhaust. Nothing too crazy. It's got a lot of suspension done to it, mainly auxiliary springs like the Roadmaster active suspension. You know, things to help me with weight. Doesn't really make the truck go any faster. But what does have a lot of work done is the transmission. So it's got a shift kit, upgraded clutch packs, Corvette's servo, Beast Sunshell gear, of course. I got the rollerized version. And it's got 2200 stall conversion. So the truck's got some things done to it. It's not a drag racer by any means, but it's a pretty fun truck to drive. Now, what I did was, I did all those things before I got my hands on the Predator. Honestly, before I was kind of scared of one. I didn't know what it was going to do. I was afraid that, I've heard horror stories that the tuners in general would make the trucks run, make vehicles run lean. I was afraid it was going to burn pistons, so what I decided to do is go on, hop on the internet, talk to a few people, and find credible companies that have been in the business for a long time and would provide me with a safe product. So what it boiled down to is, I decided to get the Predator. Why did I pick the Diablo's Predator? Mainly because it was a flash tune. I didn't want to have gauges or controllers all over this truck. I wanted to keep it clean. So what I liked about the flash tune was, I could just plug in the truck, change my settings, and unplug it, drive away. I also have a remote start in the vehicle, and they seem to work fine hand in hand. So, how does the truck drive? Well, I had, like I said, all those mods done before, and you know what? The truck drove way better than stock. You know, it breathed a lot better. It drove pretty good. And after I had the transmission done, it was really nice. You know, I had nice crisp shifts, not too hard, but they're nice and firm. This truck can bark it into second gear, which is nice when you floor it. It's probably not that nice on my U-joints and everything, but that's another story. But when I got the DiabloSport, the truck just came alive after. Honestly, tuners are basically icing on the cake. After everyone knows, when I first got the transmission done, the factory tune would overcompensate and my shifts got really soft and mushy again, you know, that really smooth shift. After putting the DiabloSport in there, firm the shifts right up again. I didn't really play the parameters too much. I don't want to mess around. I just went with whatever the 87 tune was. And the truck just drives awesome. Like, all the way through the RPM range, it builds power, it shifts great. You know, you don't really notice it too much. Like, if you're nice on this truck, it drives pretty docile. Like, it drives like a factory truck. It doesn't shift hard all the time. Fuel economy-wise, if I don't hammer on it all the time, it drives pretty nice. Like, I haven't really measured it, but I haven't noticed any worse gas mileage, at least. And it definitely makes a lot more power. That sounds nice. But yeah, that's basically what I have to say about the DiabloSport. It's basically any credible tuner, it's icing on the cake. Your vehicle's going to drive a lot better. You're actually going to make use of all those mods that you put in. That's the thing. You know, you put all these mods in your vehicle, you've taken care of the physical aspect of things. But unless you tell the factory computer
to make more power and to adjust your fuel ratios and your spark curves, you're not actually taking advantage of it. Carburetors are cool because you can change that stuff mechanically by tuning your carb and adjusting your timing. But on a vehicle like this, you know, there is no distributor. I can't adjust the timing unless I tell the computer to change the timing. You know, you can't change how much fuel is delivered by changing a screw on something. It's all done through injectors. It's all computer controlled, which is nice because if you're not too tech savvy, it's pretty easy. Just plug it in and go. There is a premium tune for these tuners. I haven't tried it yet. You make a lot more power apparently, but you know, you're gonna spend more money because you have to use premium, but if that's what you want, it's there for you. And yeah, like the cool thing is, like I mentioned in the other parts of the video, you can adjust tire sizes so your speedo is correct, you know. At least on the Chevys you can. I tried doing my buddy's Ford, I couldn't change the tire sizing on that, so that's kind of a downer. But you know, I have to say, like, I definitely recommend this for the price of an intake. About $300 roughly is what I spent on it. Yeah, I know it's expensive in Canada. It's totally worth it. The truck's just like a new truck.